Cota with three assists. Cota so important to North Carolina from a tempo standpoint. He's got to control the tempo of the game. He's got to make it more or less a half-court oriented game, not a transition game.
You know, Dick, really lost in the talent pool for Duke. Avery's statistics this year, he's 11th in scoring, 7th in field goal percentage, he is 5th in free throw percentage, he's 1st in three-point percentage, and he is 2nd in assist-to-turnover ratio.
I know.
This guy is having an all-conference season.
Well, he's having an outstanding year stepping in for Wojciechowski. But the bottom line is, when they got two supers and Langdon and Grant, he's not going to get the PR. What a game, El. What a game Mr. Cote is having. As he stepped it up, he's a PT beard tonight, baby.
He's got 12 of North Carolina's 33.
They can't handle him at the point, Mike. They cannot handle him.
He has seemed to be able to penetrate whenever he wants to. Grand against Haywood, almost walked and did.
Size really bothered him right there. The size of Brendan Haywood created that turnover. Look at Mike, look at Mike. Look at the fire. Is he fired up?
Ed Cota with a spectacular first half. He has a dozen to keep Carolina close.
Mike, Ed Cota has been spectacular in the first half. He's got 12 points, and he's done it all with the ball in his hands. He's been great off the dribble, and it's been hard for Duke to keep up with him because he's got the ability when he gets it inside to finish. They've been over-pursuing the ball. He's been crossing them over and getting into the lane, and nobody can really help out because they're so concerned with North Carolina's big guys. When that ball goes up on the glass, North Carolina has been doing a great job on the offensive boards. Duke just trying to knock it out if they can't grab it, Mike.
Jay, I think you're absolutely right. In North Carolina, trying to play to its strength, and so far it has worked. Although the point total would indicate it's in favor of Duke at 38-33. And I'm talking about the number of points being scored and the tempo. Haywood down low against Brand. Turnaround misses. Brand with a rebound, starts the break. Avery against Cota. And the rebound to Eftimov. Oh, Elijah comes out. He'll wait for help.
Avery cannot play one-on-one with Ed Cota. Ed Cota's won that matchup all night one-on-one.
Here's Eftimov.
Nice.
Very strong, and he got inside, but it was partially blocked by Battier, and then a foul inside. Battier, such a wonderful defender, even though he was beaten on that first step.
Gonna take a look on the inside now. There's the good head fake. Played on a French Army team, suspended for 18 games because he played on a club team.
We go into the one-on-one situation, the 17 foul on North Carolina. Duke has committed 6. As a team, this is a very good free throw shooting bunch. Battier only at 69-6. They have a gaudy 72-18 percentage. Missed that free throw, but the long rebound comes right to Langdon. Avery, nice penetration that time and score.
Well, there's no doubt he's got his scoring game on tonight, but he's got to lock up a little bit more on the defensive end. He's got to become a Yale man and lock him up. Cota's having his way.
Owens worked on by Langdon.
He's got to get the ball over. He's going to turn it over.
Is it a five-second call or a foul? No, it's a hold on Trajan Langdon. The crowd didn't like that one. Number 2 on Trajan Langdon, and Mike Krzyzewski up voicing his protest.
Well, I don't blame him. I thought they could have had a five-second count. Now, here's Avery trying to keep the ball away from Cota. He knows once Cota has it in his hands, he's really in trouble. So right now, he's trying to deny him the basketball. He's saying, no, no, no. I'm not going to let you touch it, Eddie.
Carolina will now shoot one and one. And Owens misses the front end, but an offensive rebound to Okalaja.
There it is, Okalaja. All the little things, the intangible guy. He made my all-intangible team last year. Okalaja against Spaghetti.
Haywood, little fadeaway, won't go for it. Offensive rebound to Owens. Nice job by Okalaja to save it. Owens at the baseline. Offensive foul. No, check it, no foul call. They say he stepped out of bounds. A lot of contact and no call either way.
You're going to watch Battier make this happen. Look at Battier trying to, I thought he fouled him. I thought he fouled him prior to him stepping out there.
Well, it's got to be a call one way or the other, doesn't it?
Yep.
Shane Battier leads this club with 21 charges taken. That time he was really spread out.
Shane Battier is one of those kids that does all the little things. He's one of those underrated guys that you have to win. when you talk about potentially a team to win the national title.
McGetty in rhythm and missed. A lot of long rebounds tonight. And there is a travel after the rebound on Elton Brand. Couldn't keep his balance.
Offensively, they forced Haywood in the last possession to shoot a fadeaway jump shot at 7 feet. They'll allow that all night long. You know, I know Richie used to say that all night long, baby. Oh, nice backdoor cut.
Oh, Kalijah, the bucket and the foul. Great job by Carolina again running its offense.
See, that's what I talked about earlier. Okalasha's got to take advantage of McGetty with the experience versus the diaper dandy on a defensive end. Now watch him right here. We're going to see it right here. He's going to run a little backdoor cut, set him up, freeze it right here. He catches him, goes backdoor, and he's going to get the layup. There it is. Okalasha reading the play perfectly, and McGetty gets caught staring at the basket. Good, good decision right there to go to the experience versus the youth.
Okalaja showing that senior leadership and the knowledge of the offense, something becoming less and less frequent in college basketball.
They don't go away. They're not going away. I'll tell you one thing. This club really believes they're good. A lot of people don't believe they're good.
Okalaja tries to draw the charge. McGetty with his own follow.
McGetty's so active. Best pure talent as a freshman in the ACC. Nice cut.
Okalaja again.
Can't play him. See, he's not seeing ball, man, Mike, and that's a no-no. And Okalaja anticipates it and runs the backdoor cut. I think Bill Guthridge maybe seen something happen like that and has taken advantage of McGetty.
McGetty drains a three.
He says, I'll tell you what, I'll trade you, Okalaja. You take two, I'll take the trifecta. And oh, they jump up with joy here at the camera.
45-38. Let's check in with Jay Billis. Jay, something so far, isn't it?
Mike, Corey McGetty fell in practice yesterday and received a hip pointer on his left thide, but he took treatment all today, and Mike Krzyzewski told him, nobody comes hurt, nobody comes sick. You come to play, Mike.
That's the psychological advantage of being the coach, and Mike can talk about that because he's got the bad hip.
Look at Okalaja. He's hanging around the basket. There he is with the offensive rebound. Discovered out there in Germany. Henrik Rodel played with Henrik Rodel from years ago. And I believe it was Roy Williams that went out there and helped to recruit him.
Played on a club team in Berlin.
No, it couldn't be Roy Williams because Roy Williams already gone at Kansas. Roy's son on a team here at North Carolina. Before the game, really nice young man.
Okalaja doing a great job in the latter stages of the half. He has 14. The lead's been cut to four.
He has 45 points, and Langdon has not been able to find his jump shot.
McGetty gets caught up in the lane. Avery outside. Shot clock at 18. About a 10-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. The 20-second timeout called by Mike Krzyzewski.
Duke has some date here next Wednesday when Maryland comes in town. I'll tell you, that Duke-Maryland basketball game, I did the first one, Mike. It was tied at halftime, and then Duke just put a suffocating defense. Carawall held Francis without a field goal the second half.
And here's the final line on that game. It was an 18-point victory. Brand was huge. And as you said, Steve Francis held to 11 points and shot only 37%. I read in the paper the other day, he said if this kind of thing happens again and his shot is off, he knows exactly what to do. Coming up next Wednesday, we'll be right back here. Maryland against Duke. And it could well decide first place in the regular season championship in the Atlantic Coast Conference.
Think about this. The last team to go undefeated in the ACC was back in 1987. Dean Smith's club, and nobody's done it since. Duke went 15-1 to win the most games ever. But they got a chance to run the table this year. They really do. It's not going to be easy, but they got a chance.
Well, there's a few more they have to get by. Shot clock down to five. Carawell fires one up. The rebound to Curry. And Carolina can play for the last shot. They're down by only four.
Curry's giving them some positive minutes tonight. He's got four shots.
Avery down the lane with left hand. Couldn't hit it. Got his own ball. Put it up. Can't hit it again. And Burgess with a rebound.
Really good half, though, Mike. North Carolina's going to be happy to only be down four. Adebolo Okalaja really came up big with 14 points, five rebounds, Oh, we got a good second half going to come up, Mike.
Oh, Elijah hit 5 of 7 shots. It's a four-point game. Let's check in with Chris Fowler. Chris.
Mike. North Carolina continues to run their system. Mike.
Hey, Mike, I'll tell you a stat that was big right there. 2 for 12 North Carolina allowed Duke from the perimeter. In their 5 wins in the ACC, North Carolina shut down the three-point shot to the tune of 20% per game.
Trajan Langdon was 0 for 4 in the first half. Bounce pass to Kota from Okalijah, and the two veterans getting it done.
And there's another example. Movement without the ball, the little backdoor cut. Duke doing a very poor job defending the backdoor cut.
Langdon got another good look and another miss. 0 for 5 from long range for Trajan Langdon.
Eddie Kota and Mr. Okalijah have really taken it upon themselves to try and get back to Chapel Hill with a win. The two veteran players have stepped up big time. I was going to say two seniors. I mean, I think Kota's like a senior.
Okalijah goes to the floor. This will be a jump ball situation. The ball will go to Duke.
He is playing his card out, Mike. He is playing his card out, Adamoto Okalijah. Here's a look at Bill Guthridge. 51 wins already in his career. 34-4. What a gentleman. Just a super young man. I call him young because he's only in his second year as a head coach.
Compared to you, he is young.
Oh, he is young. Everybody's young compared to me.
Okalijah hitting the head on that play as he got an elbow from Battier. They can ill afford to lose him.
See, Owens now coming right on and Langdon, not allowing him to get the look at the three-point shot.
Grand nowhere to go, decides to do it himself over Haywood and did not get the roll. And another rebound to Okalijah. That's 6 boards tonight for Adamola.
They're giving him one shot right now, Duke.
2 could tie it. A 3 would give Carolina the lead. Nice reach in by Grand, but it's picked off by Ed Kota, who ties the game at 45.
Ed Kota showing some medium range right there, knocking down the 15-foot shot. Here comes the fans trying to give him that sixth man, the Cameron Crazies.
Ed Kota now with 16 points.
It has been like a Final Four run for Duke. The game down at St. John's at Madison Square Garden, Mike Krzyzewski talked about that as being like a Sweet 16 game. Now he said you're set up 3 days later and you're playing like in the great Final Eight. It's just a great way to get ready, and they know something about winning as you see back-to-back national titles for Coach K.
How about this? Okalijah with 14, Kota with 16, the rest of Carolina's roster with 15 points.
But isn't that the way it's supposed to be? Your stars are supposed to come and play and make it happen.
And that's not the way it's supposed to be. Trajan Langdon with a missed free throw. He had hit his first 2 tonight. Leads the ACC not only this year, but all time in free throw percentage. Barely ahead of the all-time record by 0.2%. It's the second one.
I'll tell you, that's like a scoop you got. When he misses one, it's like a scoop. It's like an unbelievable story. What do you call it here? Give him another one? Oh, no, they wanted you to be able to get the perspiration off the floor.
They had a real problem in that in the first half. They ran out of dry towels. They had to go get some more. And Okalijah spending some time on the bench still working on that eye. They may have been poked there as well as being hit in the top of the head.
They need him on the floor. You know, last year, 2 out of 3 North Carolina won. They were up 17 here. And ultimately, the heat and fatigue really wore down their 6 players because they played 6. And Duke was able to prevail by a deuce.
Avery has had a tough time with Kota all night long. Kota has seemed to be able to go by him each time he wanted. This is Curry.
Yeah, it's been an M&M or mismatch. He hasn't been able to handle him.
Curry takes it low to Haywood.
Curry's giving him positive minutes, Mike. When in doubt, throw it up to the 7-footer, to Space Eater.
Langdon. Finally got one after missing his first 5. That was pure.
Just a matter of time. He is silky smooth from the perimeter. I don't care what those numbers say thus far tonight. He is a great shooter.
And now you'd better watch out. Owen Wiggins nearly threw it away and does, as Kota can't catch it before it goes in the backcourt. The 10th turnover by North Carolina.
Former Kansas State guy, Mr. Guthridge, was a roommate with Gene Katie. As you're going to see, Trajan Langdon square his body, gets a good look. No hand in his face. I can't believe they didn't put a hand up in his face. Look at the rotation. The Alaskan Assassin.
49-47 Duke.
Inside, outside. It doesn't get much better than Brandon Langdon.
Brand over Haywood. Pretty good defense, but Brand hits from 12.
When you make the perimeter jump shot, it makes him so much more effective down in the boxes. And here come the Cameron Crazies.
The lead is back to four. This is usually where Kota shines when the other team has been on a little run.
Every fan should try somehow to get in here one time.
Curry dumps it to Haywood. Battier with a rebound. Starts the break to Avery.
Give it up. Give it up. There it is.
Avery does, and Carowell with a layup.
Get a little T.O., baby, baby. 22nd. The Dukies are on a run.
16:25 to go in the game.
They need a basket here, Mike. They need a basket here to shut this momentum down.
Haywood tried to dribble in the lane. Tied up. Now a jump ball situation. And the ball will go back to Carolina because that is such an odd way. They have written that rule. The last team that really had it was Duke, so when Carolina dove on it, it's their defensive possession.
Mike, I've said it once. Brent Musburger said it. Brad Nessler said it. I've said it. You got to throw the ball up and let's play basketball. These rules like that are just not working. They're too unbelievably difficult to decide what's happening. The defense this year, the rule is supposed to get the basketball if they create the tie ball. And many a times there's been an indecision. Let them throw it up. Put strategy back in the game.
Well, if the officials can't throw it up, let's have a five-minute clinic to teach them how to throw it up. They can do everything else.
But if they don't throw it up right, it's for both clubs. I mean, what intensity and emotion in this game. I said it earlier. Every fan should try somehow once in their lifetime, if they're basketball fanatics, to get into this arena. I mean, it's so special. There are a lot of great special places. Certainly Chapel Hill is special when you see all those banners. But when you have the students right on top of the action, here they give this building to the students.
Should we give out your home number so they can call you for the ticket?
Yeah, I'll get them a ticket. Just write me care of ESPN. Yeah.
Good luck on that one.
I call Tom DeGarmo. He runs this building.
Curry double team, nearly taken away by Battier. Good anticipation on defense.
Mike, before we get too far in this game, I told a lot of people today, and they told me to say hello to you, in a visit for the V Foundation over at the Duke Cancer Center. A lot of fans watching tonight. We send our love and our best wishes to all those beautiful people I had a chance to visit with today.
Absolutely. Very nice of you to go over there and do that, Dick. I'm sure it lifted some people's spirits.
Look at this penetration. See, beat him that time. Oh, but not.
Then relaxed, beat him again. Offensive rebound, Dakota dumps it off and knocked in.
Lang inside with that big
Chris Lang.
He just can't play him head to head, but there aren't many guys that can play him head to head. Avery having a tough time defensively against Ed Cota.
That time Cota had a tough one against Langdon, picked up his second. We've got a timeout with 15:39 to go in the ball game. Duke leads by four.
The second half, and one of the things that North Carolina has done extraordinarily well tonight, and they do well all season long, is rebound on the offensive end with those big bodies. North Carolina gets great angles with their big guys. They go up with two hands and they get a lot of stick backs in that first half. They were always on the offensive glass using two hands, going up, getting fouled, and going to the free throw line. Even Ed Cota was doing a good job of getting into the act. Guards not used to blocking out, and Cota took advantage of that on his drives, getting some easy baskets and also a nice dish off to Chris Lang, who had his hands ready.
You know, Jay Billis is a television producer's dream. It's 102 degrees in here, and by sheer force of will, he refuses to sweat.
I know. It's unbelievable. Keeps that jacket on. Well, he's home right now. We got Brad Daugherty down in Bristol. We should get those two suckers to play one-on-one. Daugherty was such a polished player when he wore that uniform for the Tar Heels.
They played one-on-one a lot.
I wish I had the looks of those two guys. I mean, I'm so ugly. If I could only have half their looks, I'd make it a TV. This is so... Oh, nice.
Nice skip pass to Carowell. Backs out. Nearly got caught in the air. Avery down the lane. Forces it up and got it.
See, Avery's making him pay on the other side. Now he's got to really take pride in himself defensively. That's where Bob Hurley excelled when he was a point guard at Duke. He was such a stopper on a defensive end. Got cut the other day by Vancouver.
Elijah, good pass inside to Lang, lost it on the way up. That's because he was fouled by Trajan Langdon. This is a great concept. ESPN Sports Century, countdown of the top 50 athletes of the past century this week. Number 49, the great running back O.J. Simpson. If you want more, ESPN.com, part of Go Network, go.com.
Dan Patrick did a great one on Chris Everett. I really loved it. It was beautiful, 30 minutes. Watching that star talent. I can't wait to see when they get down to number one. Could it be Muhammad Ali? Could it be Michael Jordan? Wow.
Athlete of the century, I think my vote would have to go to Muhammad Ali. I think he might be the athlete for eternity.
He is such a person. I used to love it when he used to say, give me an giant, blend it in five. Dare to call me a bum, I'll knock you out in a one, the Sonny Liston. And then he backed it up.
I can't wait to see the one on Arnold Palmer.
Yeah, that'd be a great one. I'll tell you about Muhammad Ali. His prime to take Tyson, Holyfield, all of them the same night, put him behind his back and say next.
55-51 with 14:46 to go in the ballgame. Duke leading by four. North Carolina hanging around in the vicinity.
See, this is what North Carolina likes, though. They said, okay, we can play you 5-on-5. We like this kind of scenario because it really plays to our tempo.
Carroll with a hanger. Haywood, nice job of blocking out. Brand got there late and retrieved it.
They've done a pretty good job, the young guy Haywood inside on Elton Brand, who's been dominating people. But tonight, he's really doing a pretty good job on him. Well, he's a prolific scorer at the point guard slot. Now he's got to lock it up defensively. See, it's whatever you can do, I can do better. Now Cota's going to try to beat him off the dribble. They should get some screens out here for Cota. He did a good job right there. He made him kick the ball back out.
Okalija with a runner. Eftimov tried to keep it alive and came over the back to commit the foul.
That was a great defensive sequence right there for Avery. He made Cota pick up the ball and kick it back out. Now we're going to see him on the offensive end against Curry. There's the screen. Curry runs right into the screen, and he spins on the inside of Eftimov, who didn't do a good job of hedging, of stepping out and closing off that angle. You got to close off the driving angle. Come out of Augusta, maybe Ricky Moore in the backcourt, the outstanding defensive player. I think he's the best perimeter defensive player in America, Ricky Moore of Connecticut.
Brand appeared to be limping as he went to the bench. Long range by Avery. The rebound to Curry. Left alone. He keeps penetrating. Puts it up. And a blocking foul called. The Duke fans wanted the charge. Battier could not draw it.
Avery seems to be a little bit better in terms of his basketball skills than I've witnessed a little bit earlier this year. I think that's going to happen with experience. You're going to see Curry right now head up. Look at those eyes. What an outstanding quarterback. The coaches at North Carolina feel he's heading for greatness, Mike.
He's also got that tremendous adjustment to make from high school, Dick. I think with his athletic ability and his quickness, he just destroyed people in high school. You come to this level in the ACC, you can't do it.
Well, he was two levels better than anyone. So when he stepped out and he got the basketball with his hand, and it was his system down at Hampton, now he has to play without the ball, and it takes time to learn that arm.
Curry hits the first free throw. He's only 9 out of 19 from the line this year in limited opportunities. There are his numbers as a freshman quarterback for the football team. He played very, very well after the injury.
He got an MVP award in the bowl game after only three practices. Shared time with Davenport. There's a little football game going on this week, isn't there? What's that, Super Bowl 33?
I'm concentrating on this.
Oh, wow. There's so much analysis to that thing.
This is the ACC Super
Bowl. Oh, yes.
Nate James steps out for three.
Nate James showing why he's a valuable guy off the bench. You're right, Mike. This is Super Bowl every year when these two babies hook up. And there's always electricity.
Duke is so incredibly deep and talented. No basket as Cota goes in, fouled before the shot.
Avery wanted a push off. Avery said he's pushing me off. I'll tell you one thing. Avery was challenged at halftime by Mike Krzyzewski, and you could see him coming out with a little bit more defensive pride. But is that going to be enough to stop the ball handling wizardry of this kid number 5 from New York City?
Owens will come back in for Bill Guthridge. Mike Krzyzewski sends Brand back out on the court, and Battier will get a rest.
Last year was so different, as Brent Musburger and I said, as the Carrion Hoder going off. Wow. Wow.
Elevating his left ankle, now grabbing his knee.
Well, that is bad, bad news for North Carolina.
Well, this really limits Bill Guthridge at a point guard spot. He really doesn't have anybody.
Well, Curry's going to have to step up, and that's asking a lot of a kid who doesn't really know their system that well.
And somebody they have used as a shooting guard. That's blocked by Brand, so he really hasn't worked at that spot. They do have Brad Frederick that they could bring in. They do have Terrence Newby, who would come in for a few seconds each game to spell Kota. But that is a huge loss.
Well, we'll chart this. 7-point differential, 13 on the clock when he went out.
Curry down the lane, had it partially blocked. The follow won't go. The rebound to Burgess.
Duke's going to make them pay now with Kota on that sideline.
The lead is 7. They have a chance to blow it open. Brand into the lane, fouled before he got there. It looks like Lang with a hold.
North Carolina's got to be very careful to a Duke spurt, usually started by their defensive pressure, something that hasn't happened a whole lot here tonight. I just love the uniforms. I look at those Carolina uniforms. I just love the color of those suits. And you think about all the greats that wore the uniform for Duke and North Carolina.
Beautiful defense by Lang, anticipating the pass, came down the baseline.
They're putting the ball in the hands of the diaper dandy, Mike. Very inexperienced, Ron Curry.
Kota is up. It looks like they're retaping that ankle, and Haywood gets the bucket and draws the foul from Burgess on top of it.
Well, the one thing they've done well with Haywood, they've kept him away from being a dunking machine on the inside, but he shoots over the top, a little jump hook from the baseline. There it is, a baseline jump shot, little jump hook by the 7-foot sophomore.
Haywood now with 7 points. I honestly thought they needed a much bigger offensive night from him to have a chance tonight, but it hasn't turned out that way because of Avery and Okalijah.
And because of Kota. Kota's great performance.
I mean Kota and Okalijah.
And the two stars have stepped up.
James. Burgess.
Nice pass.
Brand can't hit it, and he's fouled.
Burgess made the good look on the interior to Brand with baseline passing. I'll tell you one thing, James has really accepted his role. He was a McDonald's High School All-American. He has accepted his role coming off the bench. They got 9 high school McDonald All-Americans, Duke. 9. Domzalski was one as well. There's the little pass on the inside. Brand goes to the free throw line. Great student in high school out of Peekskill, New York. Once the home of the New York Jets training.
Elton Brand only 1 out of 3 from the line tonight.
They don't normally, Duke is excellent on a free throw line. They shoot better than 70% as a team.
Missed them both. Burgess tried to tip it out and can't. The lead is back to 4. Carolina can cut it further. Okalijah left alone for 3. Goes in with a left hand. His tip won't go. And Burgess was out of bounds when he and Langdon got it back.
Surprised that Adebola didn't shoot that basketball. Had the wide open 3 and has been shooting this year 43%. But there he is going to the basket. Tough shot there with the left hand. Didn't have the good angle.
He doesn't have enough attempts to rank among the league leaders, but he would certainly be in the top 5 if he did.
Same with Haywood on the inside. Hasn't had enough made goals to rank as an all. Look at this inside jump hook again.
Lang really has some quickness.
Brad Daugherty could talk about it with Chris Fowler in the studio, but Bill Guthridge is a phenomenal teacher of big man plays. When he worked under Dean Smith, who obviously all of us know, one of the greatest coaches in the history of the game, Bill Guthridge was assigned working with big men and teaching them post moves. He has not given that up. He works with the big men constantly, and that man is a teacher.
Dick, how many guys have we seen over the years come to North Carolina? Guys you could accurately describe as freshmen as stiffs or projects. Guys who weren't going to do anything by the time they were juniors and seniors. They were big-time players.
Martin Salvadori.
We'll be back in a minute. 2-point game. These teams, it's not always the games that coaches remember, but the dramatic plays and the players that made them.
We had Jordan, Dawkins, Perkins, Allery, Ferry, Leitner, you know, Carter, Jameson, you know, the magnificence of play.
Just, there have been some classic matchups. It's been a lot of fun. You know, if you don't enjoy games like this, then you should have a different profession.
You should also have your head examined.
John Feinstein wrote about it in his great book about the ACC. The fact that makes it so interesting tomorrow when a lot of people go to work, you got a situation where you're working with a Duke fan, North Carolina fan. When you're in this area, you're going to love one or the other.
Well, how about when they go home? This separates families.
Exactly.
Let alone co-workers.
There's the zone right now defensively. Got to find a gap in that zone. Kick it out in the gap.
Shot clock at four. James misfires from long range. Curry with a rebound, knocked away. Curry comes out with it, and then he's fouled by Battier. That is going to be four on Shane Battier.
One Curry is...